founded in 1905, Badger Meter recently celebrated over 100 years in business. Throughout its history, Badger Meter has been and continues to be a proud employer of a diverse workforce. Badger Meter also supports diversity news and analysis through its sponsorship of the Focus on Diversity program with yours truly, Troy Shaw.
And now back to Focus on Diversity with Troy Shaw.
And welcome back to the program. Let's continue on with our discussion. Colum Condemned, an editor of a weekly newspaper calling itself the Voice of Asian America, apologized after Asian American and city leaders condemned a column entitled Why I Hate Blacks. Asian Week contributor Kenneth Ng listed in his article reasons why he supports discrimination against blacks, including because they are the only race that has been enslaved for over 300 years. I really don't know what to say. I mean, because you typically don't get this kind of rhetoric from Asian Americans. What do you think there, Mike?
Well, I guess I would start off by asking Robert, how in the world did this editor not see this column and let it get through at least the first round of publishing? I mean, come on, do they not read their own stuff?
Well, obviously the guy has a dual personality thing going on here.
I mean, you have to ask yourself really quickly, though, what would cause there to be friction with this particular Asian individual? And I would assume that there are probably other frictions with other Asians.
Well, you know, I mean, but the guy's column and his article are filled with a lot of arrogance. And the title of the column is really arrogant, too. Mm-hmm. The Voice of Asian America. Come on, who is in his right mind is going to declare themselves the voice of the Asian people?
Well,
and it was right for the Asian community to come out and condemn this, because obviously this guy doesn't speak for the Asian community. That's like me coming out the voice of the Latinos in Wisconsin. You know, my column is taking sides. I speak on my opinion on rather certain issues. Now, this individual obviously is in need of some kind of medical attention. I don't know what his problem is.
Well, he even made a column that said, "Why I Hate Asian Americans." So he's battling not only his own culture, but other cultures. And it's a publicity stunt.
Dual personality issue going on, right?
Let's have another publicity stunt that let's try to get
there. There is something to be said for race relations between people of all colors. Of course, you know, I think the most antagonism right now in America is, you know, between African Americans and Caucasians. But we never examine if there is a problem between, say, Asians and African Americans, Asians and Hispanics, Hispanics and blacks. Not very often.
Troy, we have problems within our own communities with each other. Mm-hmm. Of course there's going to be problems with Latinos and blacks with Asians.
But we
Asians
don't talk about it very
but,
often.
But we,
it's always
we,
a black
we,
and white issue.
We do talk about it. We do see it. We see it at the national level. That's why at the national level there are conferences about our differences and how we can find common ground with our people. It's only when knuckleheads like this come out with idiotic columns like that bring people to say, what's going on here? And, you know, great, it started the public debate, but the overall issue of trying to get along with each other is being addressed at national and local levels. Mm-hmm. What needs to be done is for the media to promote it more than they do, because they always highlight the separatist kind of notions, the nationalist kind of ideas, the anti-black, anti-Latino statements made by knuckleheads like this.
Chris?
Yeah, I have a lot of problems with other white folks as well, so we've got our own issues to deal with. So when you look back and forth between the races, oh yeah, we got our own issues, first
so
of all.
You hate white people too?
I hate white people. Frank the Angry White Man, I hate white people.
Well, see, that's
people don't understand that.
That's very interesting. As a white individual can say that they don't like another white individual, we never think about the context of their race when they say it. But when another race of individuals say that they have a problem with somebody else that's ethnic, well, then this becomes a front page story.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
Oh, so what do you think?
Well, it also becomes a front page story when people like Bill Cosby criticize other blacks.
Of course. Yeah.
I mean, there's all
sure.
kinds of criticism flowing back and forth.
Mm-hmm. I didn't appreciate it.
There's all kinds of criticism flowing back and forth. I mean, there's race relations is not something that appeared miraculously 30 years ago. It's been part of this part of the history of the world, and it'll always be a part of the history of the world, because we're different peoples.
And I think that for the most part, as we move in this context of intermingling and interracial relationships and things like that, I think that some of those fears and some of those angers will kind of like calm down, but I don't know how long that's going to actually take. Last word on Robert.
Well, you know, ultimately, again, it's leadership that sets the tone. It's leadership that produces the kind of arguments that are rational, that are reasonable, that all can agree upon and all can live with. And then use those words and those messages to advance a stable society that we all can live in and that we all aspire to.
Very, very well said. And when we come back, we'll have our closing comments. Stay with Focus on Diversity. We'll be right back.